Hello students, welcome you again in social science class. Let's continue the chapter Law and Social Justice. Student, in this part of video I will explain you enforcement of safety laws, new laws to protect the environment and environment as public facilities. So let's start our topic, enforcement of safety laws. As the enforcer and lawmaker, the enforcement needs to ensure that safety laws get implemented. At that workplaces, the government of India should also ensure the right to life, which falls under Article 21 of Indian Constitution, is followed properly. When the UC incident took place, the safety laws were not implemented seriously in India. Even the existing safety laws, which were weak, were not enforced. The government allowed the plant to be set in the populous locality of Bhopal and even refused to recognize as hazardous consequences. In 1978, when few officials from Bhopal Municipal Board objected to the installation of this plant, the government insisted that the state needed continued investment of Bhopal plant, which should create jobs for the locals. Instead of protecting the interest of people working there, both this private company and government disregarded people's safety. This is completely unacceptable. Before approval of any industry's laws and codes must be satisfied with and after assessment, permission should be given. As both local and foreign ventures are setting up factories in India, there is a need for stronger law in order to protect the rights of workers and enforce these laws in a better manner. Next, our topic is new laws to protect the environment. What are the new laws to protect the environment? Until the 1984, there were very few laws in India in order to protect the environment. Further, they were hardly enforced. The industries were allowed to pollute water and air in India without any fear. They treated the environment as a free entity. The rivers, air, groundwater were polluted on a large scale and health of people was ignored completely. Apart from being a beneficiary of the lower safety standards, the UC did not need to spend any money in order to clear toxic waste, which was leading cause of pollution in the region. However, in the UC, the cleaning process was an important part of production itself. As the Bhopal gas disaster took place, the issues of environment got highlighted. Due to this, both people and government realized that even though existing government laws were weak, it only covered individual worker and not those worker who suffered because of industrial accident. As the pressure grew from environmental activists and others, the government of India introduced new laws related of environment 1 year after the Bhopal gas tragedy. From then onwards, the polluter was responsible for the environmental damages. The government is a resource which will be shared by each generation. One can't destroy it simply for industrial development. Under the Article 21 of the Indian Constitution, the right to life is a fundamental right. It offers pollution-free water and air to enjoy life fully. The government of India is responsible for making procedure and laws in order to check pollution and impose very heavy fine those who create it. Now we will discuss about new laws imposed by the government. During the recent time of courts in India have delivered strong order related to environment issues. Recently, by invoking Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, Naumi Gange and Rally for Rivers, government has shown its commitment towards environment protection. By imposing high carbon tax and high taxes of petroleum, government is deterring individuals from misusing these resources. At international level as well as in India, is showing its commitment towards the environment issue. students, now let's talk about the environment as a public facilities. During the recent times, the court in India have delivered strong orders related to environmental issues. Such orders have even affected the livelihood of the people. For example, a court order in Delhi asked those industries situated in Delhi's residential areas to shift out of such areas. Most of these industries were polluting the neighborhood areas and were even polluting the Yamuna's river. All such industries were set up without following any rules. However, as one problem was solved, a new one arose. As the factories closed down, many workers lost their job. Others had to shift to those far off places where these factories had been relocated. Even at the new places, the factories kept pollution unchecked and safety condition of the worker were not taken care of as well. Recent research regarding environmental issues in our country has shown that growing concern related to environmental pollution among the middle class is often at poor family expenses. For example, in the names of the city, beautification drive, often a polluting factory is moved to outer area. Awareness related to environmental concern have increased nowadays. However, there is a little concern among the worker. Now it's time to conclude the chapter. Every situation, the laws are necessary in order to protect the people from unfair practices. Business persons, private companies, contractors indulge in unfair means such as employing children in hazardous activities, paying low wages to the workers, ignoring the environmental damages, not providing safety procedures to the workers, etc., in order to gain profit. In order to control the activities of the private companies, the government should make, uphold and enforce law in order to prevent injustice. Laws which are weak in nature can cause serious harm. Laws are necessary in many situations, whether this to be the market, office, factory, so as to protect people from unfair practices. Here the role has to be played by government by making better policies and by implementing them in effective manner. So while the government has a leading role in the respect, people can exert pressure to the both private companies and the government act in the interest of the society. So main role is of the government. So students, this was our chapter Law and Social Justice. I hope you all have understood. Now we will meet again with the new topic. Till then, take care. Goodbye.